Hello there people, this is Mr. Critic and you're watching my let's play of Panzer General. So, the name of the game is North Africa Part 3, Defense for the Allies, Allied Turn 4, at least I think so. Yeah, sorry for the previous video, it was kind of short, you know, but I was dog tired. So, but it's amazing what a good night of sleep can do to you. Now I'm back, I feel like, you know, I don't know, like $1 million. No, but I'm back 100% and everything, so I still think what I said in the previous video, don't get me wrong, but you know, new day. New energy. Too bad the sun is not shining. Yeah. Also, well, as you have seen in the previous video, which is actually currently uploading, I did not have the energy to do it yesterday. So, if we are, you know, in between doing this new video now, if we are interrupted by a message that the new video has been uploaded, you know, this happens. You LPers out there, you know. But like I said, even though we had some really bad luck and also some of my decisions were pretty dumb, you know, we have crippled fighters here. Well, we achieved two things actually. Now, first, the enemy will have to spend the prestige to bring the fighters back to strength. And the AI, I think, almost exclusively uses elite replacement. So this will be expensive. Three fighters, two with the strength of one, one with the strength of five to bring back. Also, here a level bomber, you know. And the other good thing is that not all of the Luftwaffe units will reach us at the same time. You know, you get one fighter back to strength, fly it across the desert, you bring another one on the airfield, bring it back to strength, takes a, you know, one more turn, actually two, first to park it on the airfield, then to bring it back to strength, and then again fly it. As for the battle, I was looking, you know, studying the battlefield, looking at the crosses. The ground units will reach us in three turns. So we have two more turns to prepare our defenses, sorry. Air units, well, they will reach us sooner, however, one at the time or two at the time at the most. So yeah, casualties. For the time being, I know I was saying in the previous video that we are winning. Well, not in body count, we are not. But, you know, in preparation, we do. Since our line of defense is, well, basically almost done. We could use some more prestige, and I was again getting kind of wild on air defenses. The only reason for this is that, you know, like in Panzer General Forever, I understand the meaning of air defenses. Speaking of Panzer General Forever, when I was going through my previous videos, you know, adding Let's Play in the title, adding some additional information. yeah, it appears that my Panzer General Forever video with the voiceover, both Poland and Warsaw have actually a lot of views, you know. I usually get, I don't know, couple of hundreds of views over a long period of time for my videos, but Poland, I think, actually had over 1,000. And now I'm wondering if this is really so interesting to you guys and also other people, you know, because over 1,000 views means 10 times the subscribers on my channel. Then perhaps I will upload the rest of them. A little bit with the voiceover, but you know, my only explanation is that a lot of players of Panzer General believe that Panzer General Forever is so difficult that it cannot be won, and therefore they are watching these two videos. So we'll do Norway. We'll also, I will definitely upload the attack on Kursk, the Operation Citadel, since this was one of the videos. I think I only made one mistake in the entire assault, which is rare. I don't know why it happened in Kursk, but you know, we all make mistakes. But one mistake for the entire scenario, you will of course notice it, I'm pretty sure, since you are all very familiar with the game and some of you are experts as well as I am. But like I said, I will upload them. Nothing probably particularly interesting for the general public, but I want to destroy this myth that Panzer General Forever cannot be won. You know, it's ridiculous. It is more difficult, it is less interesting, you know, because there are no animations and the screen is kind of strange, but definitely you can win it, you know, no problem. First scenario, Poland is kind of difficult since you don't have Luftwaffe and no advantage in experience, but later on, yeah, it's, you know, it's like pretty much like Panzer General, with one exception that the enemy really understands what he's doing and purchases a lot of air defenses, you know, and generally pisses you off, you know. So okay, but now today we go for 3 turns, since, you know, yesterday I've noticed that 2 turns only meant like, I don't know, 37 minutes of video or 38. Let us check the battlefield. Our defenses are here, Axis units are here, RAF is here, Royal Navy also close to the port of Tobruk. So first we'll retreat this lucky air defense that has actually survived, and we'll place it here and also support it with our fighter just in case this Italian tactical bomber decides to attack. I mean, if the unit has survived for this long, we don't want to lose it right now. One also very interesting part, the first unit that will reach us will be actually an excellent anti-tank gun in a armored transport, and probably will arrive somewhere here, take over this airfield, and then will destroy it and get plenty of prestige, because this is a very expensive unit. And now this is also now the name of the game. We need more prestige so we can, you know, do even better as far as our defensive line is concerned. So let us now deal with our defenses. Of course, air defenses south, so we, you know, we place them on this entire line of hexes. This is a British infantry, we will use it, you know, as sort of a reserve if the forward line collapses. And now for the rest of the air defenses, you go here. One will go north to protect our navy, at least one. This T-boat will leave the port, so as you can see now, we will not move our navy until the Italian navy arrives. Also, two destroyers have now reached the rest of the navy, so we'll place them here and here, and now for our heavy cruiser here. So most likely we'll have another air defense here to cover the rest of our navy, you know, just in case, and also because we have plenty of air defenses. Okay, now what do we have here? Well, even more air defenses. So this one will just go back. Yeah, this one will just go back and then disembark. Get out of the transport. This is what I meant, to protect our two destroyers and our heavy cruiser. Okay. British infantry, nothing for you just yet. And even more air defenses. So our position now is quite deadly for the enemy, I think. Okay, you can go here actually. We need one more spot. Okay, here and here. And one more air defense probably, and then we are quite safe. Also, for more reserves, we'll send yet another infantry south and yet another one. As for these two guys, we'll send them to help in the northern sector. I'm not really sure, you know, where the bulk of attack will be, since, as you can see, there are two approaches. One here where this anti-tank gun is, and one here. So, I don't know. We have to prepare, you know, for all of the options. And this is another artillery which we will definitely use here in the north. Tank goes here. Heavy weapons infantry. Well, for the time being, I think it can go. I don't know here. And now for the less optimistic part of the game. We have to watch our prestige, so for the time being I will not provide this tactical bomber with replacements, not even ordinary, but I will place this Hurricane here, since fighters will be more important than bombers in this particular scenario, at least in this period of time. So nothing elite just yet. We have still time, two more turns at least, for the enemy to reach us. Sorry. Okay. Okay, you get replacements. Nothing else to do. Yeah, I promised this actually two videos ago that I will discuss the supply problem in the desert. Well, if your unit is placed in a desert hex, if you press supply, you know, like fuel and ammo, you only get, I don't know, one ammo I think, and 3-4 units of fuel, so it's really shitty. Otherwise, you know, you get half of the ammo available and half of the fuel available, approximately. So we have to use the units that are actually in a desert hex sparingly. This artillery here has 7 of ammo, but after it fires for 7 times, you know, it takes really long time to, you know, supply it back to the full strength. But this artillery just next to it, you know, is in the city, so not in the desert, and, you know, the supply for it is pretty simple. Just click supply, get half of everything back. So this is a problem for us, but it will also be the problem for the enemy. So what do we do now? Think nothing. So let us save the game. Give the enemy its turn. Let us see what will happen. I am hoping for some of the enemy air units to arrive, so we can use them, you know, we can destroy them and then use the prestige we get. So, end. Shit! Shit! Oh! Damn it. I did not. Oh shit. But yeah, we were lucky. Very lucky, actually. This fighter should have won, but I should have placed, and I was planning actually to place the Hurricane here, where it would be out of range of this Messerschmitt 109, but then I forgot and, you know, got greedy, wanted to stay near the airfield, you know, just to make sure that we get, you know, that we have fuel and ammo on each and every turn. But okay, my bad. Let me just check what happened behind the lines. One fighter is back to full strength, the other one is still recuperating. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oh damn it. One fighter can reach actually this tactical bomber if we attack it. Do we attack it? 0, 4. Huh. Not good. Not good at all. Can we? Oh, I see it now. We have an air defense with half a strength here. So perhaps this wasn't such a bad idea, even though it was a mistake. Perhaps we can now destroy the Messerschmitt. This will, however, take a lot of thinking, so I will take a little pause now and be right back. Yo, I'm back. So, yeah. It really looks like a good opportunity to destroy a Messerschmitt 109, and we'll try to do just that. Also, for these Junkers, I'm preparing a sort of a trap. I don't want to protect this artillery. I hope the Junkers will attack the Stuka, and then we have, well, you'll see what we have. Two air defenses at full strength and one parked here with half a strength. So this will probably mean that yet another Luftwaffe unit will be destroyed. But first things first, let us first deal with this Messerschmitt 109. Yes. Now, could we please get some good luck this time, since, you know, on the previous attempt, this was really shitty. Okay, who is in range of this airfield? This is now my question. level bomber cannot harm us. This fighter can, however. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. He's in range. So we'll have to try and destroy this Messerschmitt with our other Hurricane. Or maybe no, let us try with this one. It says 1-1, but perhaps it will work, you know. And also, I do not consider RAF to be the priority at the moment. Ground units, all types of ground units, of course. Ouch, bastard. Come on, at least destroy one. At least one. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Yes. Move here. Now with our other Hurricane, I hope we can finish off this Messerschmitt. Otherwise, I will be extremely angry and start screaming again. Come on, destroy this punk. Come on. Yes! Excellent, and also, you know, for prestige, just perfect. So now our entire navy is under some sort of an air cover. Air defense cover. And artillery will now go here. What else can we do? If you can see the Italian Navy, this is exactly what I was hoping for. If just these two guys, this light cruiser and this battleship, can reach us before their support arrives, two subs, two destroyers, one S-boat, then our Royal Navy will be able to deal with them. You know, and then focus on their minions. However, I am worried about this large fellow here. If he decides to go for one of our ships, even this air defense will not be enough to stop it, since, you know, it is almost immune to air defense fire. Almost, not entirely, but, you know. Okay. So now we have more prestige available, and we should use it wisely. First, we'll just, you know, complete our plan here in the south. You can go here. You get fuel and ammo. You move south. You too. And you come closer. Now it looks like a pretty decent defense line. And we'll just provide other units that we can with fuel and ammo. Where to place our tank that will serve as a reserve. Well, first let us deal with this inf. You come here. You come here. Okay. You get fuel and ammo, and you also. Now we have, I think we have enough prestige to either purchase one artillery or more anti-tanks, more air defenses, everything, you know, so. and I still believe we should go for another air defense, but not just yet. First, one artillery here. Okay. Artilleries are expensive. You know it, I know it, but, you know, they really help in a battle, especially against soft targets. Less so against hard targets, but you know, still better than nothing. Here. Now with the rest of our prestige, I think we'll start giving elite replacements to the units that will be really hard pressed very soon. Not this one, since we are kind of hoping for the Stuka to attack it, and you know, no use giving it elite, not replacements, you know, overstrength. Okay, what to do with you? Well, I don't know, just fly around a little bit. Let us save the game and see what happens. North 009 casualties. Yeah, we now have destroyed two fighters, one tactical bomber from four. So air war is going our way. Ground war, well, we couldn't do, you know, a lot about our avant-garde units. So it's, the jury is still out, I think. When they reach our defensive line, then we'll see who is better. Okay. Let us give the enemy its turn. Did I see another elite option? Yeah, only this one. This guy here. Okay. And always happy when the enemy focuses on empty cities. We lose, I don't know, in this case 8 prestige, which is really nothing to worry about, and you know. Okay. What happened in the south? Oh, god damn it. Only one, but you know. This is a Focke Wulf. Nice to meet you, man. Fortunately, it only has one star of experience. But now, in the air department, we have nothing, actually, that can confront this Focke Wulf. So, it will be bad. We'll have to lure it here and destroy it with our air defenses. Now, we save the game. Again, I will study the battlefield and be right back. Yo, I'm back. Just wanted to say, you know, the first German song that I've ever learned in my life, I mean, not in school, you know, like, but the first real German song I have learned was when I was skiing with my father in Brunich. And there were those guys, Brunich, where is Brunich? Brunich is in Italy, but really close to the Austrian border. So, you know, you have a large German-Austrian minority there. And there were like 4 guys, you know, partying each and every night there. And one night I joined them and the song was Schnaps, das war sein letztes Wort. I will not translate it, because some children are also watching this channel. It was a good song, and we had an excellent party. yeah, so now, I have studied the battlefield and decided to actually sacrifice this hurricane. If it will be destroyed, then, well, cannot do anything about it, but at least for the price of one hurricane, we will destroy two Luftwaffe units. Also, since I see this anti-tank gun in a transport advancing, I'm pretty sure that in the next turn it will take over this airfield and we'll welcome it, of course, we'll prepare for it. One artillery goes north, one air defense. This is not for the anti-tank gun, but for the fighter that will join us. One air defense goes here, and now we attack this Stuka. Ooh, wow. Now I'm actually wondering, you stay put. Can we just... No, but this would be against what we are planning, since I want to lure this Messerschmitt here in the area of the many air defenses, so we lose our Hurricane, yeah. We will. Okay. Perhaps. Do we place it here? No. We want more air defenses, you know, around. So. Come on. Die, bitch. Now, how could this Stuka fire at the same time? You know, even with the strength of 7, I thought that it was highly likely that our Hurricane will not survive the encounter with this Messerschmitt, but now I'm almost positive. Damn it. You just get fuel and ammo, I think. But you get a lead, most definitely. So we are now waiting for this Messerschmitt 109 to attack, and then we'll destroy it. If our Hurricane survives, well, excellent. If it doesn't, you know. Well, again, my bad. Now for the Navy, as you can see, these two heavy guys are advancing, so we'll pull back all of our units with the exception of the submarine. I hate the subs, you know it, but in this case they will be useful. They, actually we have only one, so it will be useful. So we retreat basically everybody with the exception of the sub. One, two, three, four, five. So we don't have to go that far back. Just here and here. Just let me check again. I'm counting the hexes because the Italian battleship has a naval movement of 5 and a range of 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Heavy cruiser here. Light cruiser here. Sub closer. Let us just hope this will work. with the 66 prestige remaining. Now we'll again dance around a little bit. You get out of the transport. And we just supply our units. Now, the idea about this airfield. This anti-tank gun in a transport will come here. Then we'll attack it with our artilleries. We have three of them. And to finish the job, we have the Matilda. And the Matilda is not yet in range of any dangerous tank. 3H can, you know, attack and do some serious damage to the Matilda, but has a movement of 5, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So one hex short. This one, however, even though, yeah, you know, has a hard attack, my god. My English is so bad. Oh, by the way, my son is actually learning English in school, in first grade. This is kind of new in our school system, and now he's asking me, you know, for the meaning of words, and I try to help him. Only I hope that he will not pick up my accent. But, like I said, this tank, even though can do some damage, you know, to armor. Well, Matilda has a ground defense of 14, so will survive. But this anti-tank gun will not. Okay, so what now? You just get fuel and ammo. I am tempted to give elite replacements to, elite overstrength to this tank. And I'll do it. Why not? As for the rest of our units, for air defense is only fuel and ammo. You can now come. Well, we can bring another air defense in the area for the time being at least. Since our navy has retreated. So now anybody that attacks our Hurricane is doomed. Four air defenses after the attack. Let us just hope that RNG, you know. Oh, this is what happened now. Our video has uploaded. Well, the previous one, but we'll ignore it for the time being. Give me a second, please. What the hell? We need to get back to the game. Okay, we are back. Okay, nothing for the imps. I'm so tempted to give a lead to this artillery, but I will not. We need prestige for more important matters. You get nothing. What did I just see? Okay, one more quick. Okay, you get fuel and ammo. Wonderful. Our prestige is pretty low. We could purchase an anti-tank, but we will not. Since we do not need it, let us save the game. North 0 11. Casualties. Well, another tactical bomber destroyed. And we give the enemy its turn. And I think I'll do two more turns. Since, you know. Well, I promise you one, but, you know. I don't want this video to be too long. And. Okay. Wonderful. Bombing the empty airfield. Please survive, Hurricane. Please survive. Please survive. Please survive. No. I knew it. Bad luck. Okay, he went for the artillery. Good. No, only one more turn. Because now things will become complicated and I want a fresh start, you know, before this really happens. Why is the destroyer so close? Damn it. Movement 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But this destroyer can reach our sub after we attack and I don't like it. Not at all. What is here? Okay, Italian fighter back to strength and Focke-Wulf approaching. God damn it. Well, at least we will destroy this fighter now. Since we have three air defenses. And also this anti-tank gun in a transport. So perhaps even this anti-aircraft will do more damage that we have than we have received, but you know, I'm not particularly happy about anything at the moment. Okay, give me a sec to study the battlefield. Be right back. Yo, I'm back. So let us first deal with the Italian Navy. We'll use our sub and attack this battleship. Nice. What happens if we now use our heavy cruiser? 0-3. What if we use our light cruiser? 0-2. So let us sink this bastard, right? Also, I want to check with the Italian light cruiser. With the heavy cruiser, we get 0-4. With our light cruiser, we get 0-3. Okay. But our first priority, of course, is you know, the battleship, so we'll attack it first. Wonderful, and again. Hooah! And now we also bring our destroyers and T-boats closer. Okay, here, 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 and here. As you can notice, I am avoiding the port of Tobruk. Since the Italian level bomber with a naval attack of 16 is above it, and you know, not a good idea. Now we have to also destroy this Messerschmitt 109. So, attack. Good. Attack again. It's gone. And now for some, I think, futile attacks, but you know, still better than to do nothing. Let us try to destroy, or at least damage, I mean, the Italian level bomber. Excellent. Again. Bloody marvelous. Now to the south. Here is an anti-aircraft. We'll first shell it. This is once. Now when and if we attack with our tank, we will be exposed to this artillery. So let us perhaps first focus on this guy here. Just to weaken it a little bit. Die. Okay. So yeah, we'll use our other artillery to try and finish off this anti-aircraft. Then move south. No, I prefer actually losing an anti-tank gun instead of our, you know, armor. Since if we come here or here, we can be shelled, then attacked by this tank here, and then finished off by this heavy artillery. So anti-tank is not such a great a loss, you know. So come on. Very nice. Now first we'll try with the Matilda, and if it doesn't work, then we'll also shell this unit. Damn it. Only 4. Seriously? I was hoping for a better result, you know. Only 4? Okay, let us shell it. Perhaps we'll do some damage. This is actually a medium artillery, so I just wanted to say don't get your hopes up, but you have already seen the result. Come on. Too suppressed. And the result here is 1, so we'll now retreat our infantry and finish off this unit with our tank. Very nice. And I think now we have again some prestige available, which is always good. So let us see what else can we do. we give, like I said, we give fuel and ammo to the units, especially those ones in the desert. Okay. Now, what are we facing at the moment? As you can see, the Messerschmitt has arrived, and it means business. Now the only question is, do we now sacrifice our air transports to lure the Messerschmitt into the killing zone? I think this is the right thing to do. So, the same goes for this Focke-Wulf and this Messerschmitt 110 and this one also. So, okay, you can fly. Here? No, maybe one hex more to the south. Yes, and you can fly here. So now our trap is set, but our high quality, well, not high quality, but better RAF units will retreat. Since, you know, we don't want for them to get destroyed, we can fly back to this airfield. Will it help actually? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, it should help. So we'll just fly here and bring our bombers with us. Okay. We have 204 of prestige available. Damn it. Ever since I started smoking these cigarillos, they, you know, if you don't smoke, you know, well, they stop working. Sorry. Yeah. Now, do we actually purchase anything or do we save our prestige? I'm for saving the prestige, since we have no idea what we will be facing really soon. So yeah, we'll save it. Just let me check if we give some elite replacements to anyone, or at least fuel and ammo. Okay, we save the game. North 012, give the enemy its turn, and then I will decide whether or not I want to do another turn. Depends how difficult the situation will be. So, and casualties, of course. As you can see, now we are doing some damage in the ground department as well, and we have traded two fighters for five of the Axis airplanes. Okay, and level bomber. Oh, not good. Ah, but now Focke-Wulf is ours. Too bad that the enemy only went for one of our, air transports. Come on, Matilda, fight back! Evade! Yes. Wonderful. And now the naval battle begins. Also the ground battle. This we should win. Well, kind of. Allied turn 8 with 16 turns remaining. Now we'll have to retreat. But yeah, one more turn, okay guys? Now I will save the game, study the battlefield, be right back and everything. North 13. And then we finish the video. Be right back. Yo, I'm back. Before I continue with the game, just a quick message to my new subscribers. Quite a few of them in the last month or so. So, guys and gals, please don't be shy, you know. Like, dislike, comment. I don't bite. You can ask, you know, my other viewers about it. I'm actually kind of a nice person most of the time, not always. So please, do not only watch my videos, you know, comment. I like your comments, I like to reply to them. Okay, but now I have studied the battlefield and realized that we have now a lot of things to destroy. Starting with the Italian Navy. First we'll deal with this light cruiser and then we'll retreat our sub. Come on. Very nice. Now our light cruiser will attack and finish the job. And of course now our heavy cruiser will attack this destroyer. I'm so happy that the submarine has evaded, you know. Otherwise we would be in some serious shit. Now we are not, and now our destroyers, I think they are more than capable of finishing off this destroyer. And then we have basically won the naval battle. Of course, with the exception of these two subs. I hate the subs. They tend to evade, especially if there are enemy subs, and you know. Come on. And one last attack. I think this was excellent for our prestige. Yeah, it was. As for other units, we have to retreat our destroyer, but where? It could go into the port. Just let me check where the Italian... Ah, here it is. So we have one turn to bring it back to strength. Excellent. You go here, and our T-boat comes here. What else can we destroy? Now, I think this Messerschmitt 110 is also doomed. Attack. Wonderful. Now please destroy it. No! I was hoping for a total distraction, but no. It didn't go our way. The next target is the Focke-Wulf. At the moment, the most dangerous unit in the skies. So, come on. Kill it. This didn't go well. Come on, try a little bit harder. Oh, God damn it. Again? Okay, much better. Now we finish the job. Now the only problem is that because we have spent so many air defenses on the Focke-Wulf, we will not be able to destroy this Messerschmitt 109-2. So, but at least we'll damage it. Very nice. Now what? Think we'll just give elite replacements to our Hurricane. Yeah. It's a good thing to do. It costed us a lot, but you know, we need a fighter plane to deal with the bombers eventually. You two guys can just fly here and here. As for the ground units that have reached us, well, first we'll attack this unit. And now we'll destroy it. Now our artilleries are free to do other things. First, we'll attack this heavy weapons infantry. Whoa! Perfect. Stay put. Now for this Panzerjäger. This probably will not work, but we still have to try it, you know. And move south, I think, since we'll purchase yet another artillery here in the north. $236. Now the cost of this Panzerjäger is 24. The cost of this Wehrmacht heavy weapons infantry is, well, let us, you know, calculate. 84 plus 60 is 144. So more expensive means a better target. So yeah. Die. Now, our Matilda will attack but then retreat. First, we will, of course, retreat our, you know, our anti-tank gun. Plus, we'll place one of our infantry here. Okay guys, so we are back. I just ran out of disk space, but I freed some, so now let us just finish with this turn, and then, you know, finish also with the video. Where were we? Okay, now we have to retreat some of the units and also purchase another artillery. So this tank can now go here. This Matilda will attack and then retreat here. Oh, damn it. But no serious damage was done, so excellent. Initiative of 7 versus initiative of... Well, yeah. It was my bad, sorry. So now we'll purchase another artillery. Place it here. Okay. You can probably get a lead, I think, but perhaps just not yet. This is an inf, so you get... Well, nothing for the moment. 1, 2, 3, 4. I should not have placed this tank here, you know. Was a bad idea. Because now, you know, if we move our unit here, then, you know, if attacked, it will either retreat here or even be surrounded and surrender. So yeah, but this is what happens, you know, when I have to worry about other things, you know, not only Panzer General. So you get fuel and ammo. You do. You will have to retreat, most definitely. Or do we keep this unit here to lure in even more enemy fighters? Well, why not? You know, why not? Go here. We'll do some more destruction, and we still have one air transport available when we go into the counteroffensive, which we will do, and take over the city of Al-Ghaila and this Italian camp here. So, okay. You get a lead. Sure. All other units, well, you'll just have to wait for another turn. Wonderful. Casualties, as you can see, we are making some serious progress, especially this time in the naval department. We have destroyed 2 capital ships and 1 destroyer, and, you know, even though there are still plenty of Axis units around, I think we are winning. Let us save again, just in case. North 014, and then give the enemy its turn, and then we finish the video. Come on. More level bombing. Oh, god damn it. Come on, destroyer, fight back. Do something! This time, no luck. I guess 2 stars of experience count for something. Yeah. An Italian fighter is now, you know, ours. Allied turn 9. 15 turns remaining. Too bad that we have only artilleries here in the first line. So we cannot attack this fighter, but the Italian fighter will be destroyed, most definitely. Also some other units. So we save again. I hope you enjoyed this. I think this was much better than the performance I did yesterday and the day before. So thank you for watching this. All the best from Mr. Critic, and bye bye.